Hello, Dr. Vikki Peterson here from Root Cause Medical Clinic, and I wanted to talk to you today about brain fog and reasons you might be experiencing it. So, the root cause medicine understanding of brain fog. I'm going to do a couple of videos in this series, but the first one I want to talk to you about fuel. So, your brain requires a steady influx of fuel, really all your cells do, but if your blood sugar, and let me define that word, because a lot of times people go, sugar, yay, I love sugar. So when we say blood sugar, we're really just talking about your fuel level in your blood, and it's called blood sugar. But you won't get stable blood sugar by eating sugar. So just think of it as your fuel level, makes a better way to remember it. But that fuel level needs to be stable in order to have ideal brain function. And you know, if you've ever been really, really hungry, maybe you've experienced that, oh, I just can't, you know, I can't think straight because I'm just so hungry. What can happen is that brain fog can come on a more subtle level where you're not hungry, but your food is not turning into good fuel. And so your brain is suffering because of that. So we break this down by looking at what you're eating to make sure to see if the quality of your diet can be improved, or perhaps something is happening because in a negative fashion because you're eating a food you're sensitive to. Now, food sensitivities different than allergies, but common food sensitivities are gluten, dairy, our friend sugar. Again, there are others, those are just three very common ones. And what happens when you're eating something you're sensitive to, and a lot of times you don't know you are. So if every time you ate a piece of bread, you got a stomach ache, you'd figure it out probably pretty quickly. But unfortunately with food sensitivities, you tend to crave those foods, and yet they are compromising your ability to turn food into fuel, and brain fog can be one of the results. Another thing that can happen is you can eat, but because of various digestive imbalances, again, you're not turning food into good fuel, so you're not absorbing it the way you should, and as a result of that, you'll suffer brain fog. So what we do here at Root Cause Medical Clinic is we decipher where the brain fog is coming from, and if it's coming from food not turning into good fuel, there's just a few key steps to look at to figure out how to break that up. In other words, how to resolve that. So if you're eating good food, it's really turning into great fuel. And if you're not eating good food, what is it we have to change about your diet in order to do that? But if it is that fuel problem, then not hard to fix. Now, another one that's really not hard to fix is hydration. And unfortunately, Americans tend to be dehydrated in the main. And your brain absolutely needs to be hydrated. And if you're not getting your 8 glasses of water, we like them stretched out about a glass an hour. If you feel like you'll be up all night urinating, if you do it too late in the day, then just don't do it too late in the day. Give yourself a couple hours before bed. But stretching that 8 glasses out throughout the day of purified water can really make a huge difference for people suffering brain fog. And that's certainly, you know, an absolutely free thing to figure out, is just hydrate and see how you feel. And then the third one, which is also very easy to fix, maybe. So let me define my terms, is sleep. Now, if you're just not getting enough sleep because you're not putting the body to bed for enough hours in the day, then you have control over that, because sleep is very critical for the body to rejuvenate and kind of reboot itself. And so you've probably also, you know, experienced this where for some reason you were really low on sleep, or you know, you were just pushing yourself and you thought, oh, I can't think. And so that's very common. What can happen though is it can sneak up on people. So you start sleeping just 6 hours or 6.5 hours or maybe even less than that, and you go, I think I'm fine, I think I can do this. And believe me, I'm of the club that I wish I could sleep less and ideally function. But the truth of the matter is that sweet spot is 8 hours for the majority of us. And if you're not getting that over time, you will slowly get more and more sleep deprived, and brain fog can be a result. Now, the reason I said it was easy, maybe, is because if it's just simply that you're not allowing yourself to sleep enough, you know, you set the alarm and you're only allowing 5.5 to 6.5 hours, something like that, then that's something you can change readily. However, then there's the other category of sleep, which is that I put the body in the bed, it's not sleeping. So I'm having trouble falling asleep, or I'm having trouble staying asleep, or I think I'm sleeping, but when I wake up in the morning, I'm exhausted. I wonder if I slept at all. So any of those combinations of insomnia, then we have to figure out why. It's not hard. It's the answer is not a sleeping pill, but the why actually can go to digestion, it can go to your immune system, and it can go to hormones. So we kind of decipher that. But I just wanted to give you an overview of how, what the root cause medicine approach is to brain fog, because it can compromise your ability to do well at work, have fun at home. You know, somebody tells you something, you just can't remember it. It's very frustrating to not have your brain function the way you want it to, and it's not something that is difficult to fix. And so we have a very natural program. So I hope you got something out of that. And if you want to get more information, or you want to take advantage of a free consultation, then please visit our website, which is rootcausemedicalclinics.com.